So now that we know about conditions, let's look at selection. And the general form of an if statement in pseudocode if condition one, then statements, else if condition two, then statements, else if condition three, statements. And I can have as many of those else if statements as I want. And then I can also have an else statements end if. So the way this works is we start at the top and we check the value of condition one. And if it's true, then we execute this block of statements. This can be one or more statements. And then when we're done executing that block, we drop all the way down to the end if. So we skip everything else. If condition one is true, we execute this and skip everything else. If condition one is false, then we go to the next line, this else if here, check condition two. If condition two is true, then we execute the statements and then drop all the way down. If condition two is false, we go to this line, check condition three. If condition three is true, we execute the statements and then drop to the end, and so on. And if all these conditions are false and we get to else, we always execute the statements inside the else clause. So if any of the conditions is true, we execute the block of statements and then drop out. If none of the conditions are true, then we execute the else. Now, you can have zero or more else if statements, and you can have zero or one else statements. So the simplest possible if statement you can write is going to look like that. So for example, if I had a program like this, declare integer count, and then input count, display how many do you have, if count greater than five, if count less than five, then display that's not many. End if. So there's the simplest possible if statement, and then let's display a goodbye message. Okay, goodbye. So in Python, that's going to look like this: count equals zero, and then count is equal to an integer input. How many do And then if count less than five colon. So if is written in lowercase letters in Python. Instead of then, we use a colon at the end of the if statement. And then this block of statements in here is indented one tab, and that's how Python knows where the block begins and ends. So here we're just going to say, that's not many. And then we don't need an end if in Python because the indentation tells us where the block starts and stops. So here we'll just print OK, goodbye. And now if we run the program, how many do I have? Exactly five. Five is not less than five. So I drop out of the if statement and print OK, goodbye. Three, it says that's not many. So this is true. So I execute this block of statements. Then I drop out and print OK, goodbye. So if I wanted to add an else clause, else, That's a lot. And in Python, else, colon, that's a lot. So now if I run the code, if I have 3, that's not many. And if I have 6, that's a lot. And I can also do the same with an else if. So let's look at what's happening here. If the number is less than 5, I execute this and then drop out. So if I get to this clause, I know that the number is not less than 5 already. So count less than 10 actually means count is greater than or equal to 5 and less than 10. So it's basically been divided up into ranges here. And let's go ahead and run it. And let's go ahead and write the code. So LF count less than 10, colon, that's sort of a lot. So in Python, LF is else if, and then we use the same colon as before. Can run it. I have 3, that's not many. I have 6, that's sort of a lot. And I have 15, and that's a lot. So it's selecting one of these statements to run depending on the value of count. Now I can also get rid of this else and just have the else if there. So now if I type 3, that's not many, and 6 is sort of a lot, but if I type 15, it doesn't print anything at all. It just prints the OK goodbye message. So let's look at that in a slightly more real program. So declare real score and declare real, so declare string grade display. Please enter the student's score, and then input score, and then I'm going to calculate the letter grade. So if score greater than or equal to 90, then grade is the string A, else if score greater than or equal to 80, then grade is equal to B, and then I'm going to copy and paste this line, these lines, and then this will be 70 and 60, and then this will be anything else. So greater than equal to 70, greater than equal to 60, anything else, and then end if. And then I'll output like so. So let's write that in Python. And I'll copy and paste these as well. AD, 70, 60. And then this is just going to be an else. C, D, and F. And then let me copy that and print that. So let's go ahead and test it. Score of 90 is an A, 89 is a B, 75 is a C, 59 is an F, 60 is a D, and so on. Now, once again, I can have as many statements in here as I want. So, for example, I could have wow, that's a great score if the score is greater than or equal to 90. And oh, that's too bad if the score is 59 or less. Actually, less than 60. So now if I run the program, 95 is a great score. 75, I just have the grade. And 30, that's too bad.